competition return after 11 years. Of course, their story is well known to American figure skating fans. Here is Peter Carruthers with more.
It's been a long time.
28 years, yeah. It's, we've had our ups and downs, though. But basically, it's skating with my best friend, which to me is so wonderful. I'm so lucky that I'm able to say that he's my best friend.
The first high point for these friends and partners, a breathtaking world title in 1979.
It's just a magical moment, and I don't remember being tired coming off as we finished. It was like a dream. But you just knew when you were out there that, okay, this is that one performance that everyone has, and 79 was ours.
But if 79 was the high, 1980 brought the low. Days before the Lake Placid Olympic trials, Randy Gardner hurt himself in practice. He was unable to put any weight on his leg, and he and Ty had to withdraw from competition. Their hopes of a gold medal were gone.
Yeah, the experience was something that's definitely part of our history and part of skating history and part of our lives. Gosh, it was already 16 years ago. And the good part is that we were able to continue skating after that.
Although they resumed skating, the 80s were a difficult time, for Babylonia especially. A bout with drugs and alcohol led to a failed suicide attempt, a time she speaks of candidly now.
Skating was the least of the problem. It was things having to do with, you know, my family, personal problems away from the ice. Bottom line, I wasn't able to communicate.
Now becoming a mom and rebalancing her life, Ty has the confidence to communicate off and on the ice. Her partnership with Gardner and their shared love of skating have led them back to competition.
I don't think about, you know, the other competitors, really. I just know what we have to do, and we just care about how we look when we're out there, and we want people to enjoy what we're doing.
Yeah, I think I want to end up vertical after each performance.
We don't want to fall, yeah.
Ty Babylonia and Randy Gardner. And here they come. Following an incredible performance by our current leaders, Hartshorn and Zwiding, known simply as Ty and Randy.
I know. camels.
Together for nearly three decades. The heartbreak of the Olympics in Lake Placid in 1980, when an injury to Randy Gardner prevented them from entering a competition in which they were favored as world champions, that is all behind them now.
They were a class act then, they're a class act now, and with this choreography by Sarah Kawahara, she's really brought out the true beauty of Ty and Randy skating.
Well, I, along with everyone in this building, are very happy to see them back on the ice again. And they truly have a special quality to their skating that I don't think we have seen or ever will see.
We knew the story, we felt the heartbreak, and to see them again is really wonderful.
This is the back hand-to-hand press. All of the weight on both of his hands. And Ty really enjoying skating.
The first of their three performances in these Legends Championships is now complete. And here are their scores. 9-6s, 9-7s, and 1-9-8 for a total of 48.4. And that puts them provisionally in third place. Welcome back, Ty and Randy. Coming up, Radka.